So I want you to imagine that we're in building committee and we're trying to decide if we can actually put a heliport on top of a four-story building, and the first story below the heliport is going to be small babies and moms. And below that is going to be a CT and MRI scan.
It's very important to control noise in our environment, again, because we want to create an atmosphere that doesn't add more stress onto what the laboring woman is already going through.
The problem really was solved on paper, and we did that by creating an audio simulation and giving the hospital team an experience where they could sort of hear what the helicopter noise would sound like through different windows, different ceilings.
To be able to sit in a room and hear how the helicopter was going to sound and the vibrations that it created through different types of glass and different types of structure was extremely helpful.
It gave us confidence that yes, we can design a heliport for Markham Stouffville Hospital and do it in a way that will not compromise the babies and the moms, will not compromise CT and MRIs, and will enhance the patient's experience when they need to be exported.
So today is really exciting for us because we get the opportunity to actually validate our work and our design by wiring the hospital with 15 channels of sound and vibration sensors in order to capture how noise and vibration is going to impact different components in different areas of the hospital here today at Markham Stouffville. Today was really exciting for me personally because it gave me the opportunity to see the results live. And what it showed us was in real time we saw the success of our design.
So today, going up in the helicopter, the best part of course was knowing that what we had planned and designed over 6 years ago worked. It is safe to land. It is not noisy. It doesn't compromise our diagnostics. What this does is it helps us give better care, faster care, to the community who absolutely deserves it.